Good morning, Prairie Trace Hawks. My name is James from Ms. Leatherman's class.
And I'm Drake, also from Ms. Leatherman's class, and welcome to this edition of WPTE.
What an amazing week we had. We're getting closer and closer to summer every day.
And Iron is finally over. Great job, everyone.
Hey, you want to hear a joke?
Sure, I love jokes.
What do you think of that new diner on the moon?
I don't know.
Food was great, but there wasn't really much atmosphere.
That's so funny.
All that laughing is making me hungry. What's for lunch today?
Today's hot lunch is Bosco sticks with broccoli.
Sounds good. Drake, is anyone celebrating the birthday of Prairie Trace today?
There are no birthdays today.
Well, Miss Gerda will be happy to continue to celebrate her birthday for a second day in a row.
Next up is Malek with the weather. What can we expect this weekend?
Good morning, Prairie Trace Hawks. I'm Malek, and welcome to this week's edition of weather. On Friday, it will be a high of 65 and a low of 51. There will be a 90% chance of rain. I'm going to stay inside my house when it rains. On Saturday, it will be a high of 58 degrees and a low of 49 and 20% chance of rain. It will be very cold. On Sunday, there's a high of 71 and a low of 58. It should be sunny, so make sure you go outside and play. Temperatures for next week are looking toasty. So that's something to get excited about. Thanks for watching. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Mark. Look like it's going to be a cloudy weekend.
Next up, we have Lily with sports.
Oh, hi. I'm Lily from Mrs. Van Dam's class, and this is sports. For baseball, we have the Indianapolis Indians playing this weekend on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, playing against the Louisville Bats. Also on Friday, for women's basketball, we have the Indiana Fever playing the Washington Mystics. And on Sunday, the Indiana Fever are playing the Los Angeles Sparks. And it's officially May, so you know what that means. It's Indy 500 time. It's an Indiana tradition. Have you ever been? Well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Now back to the studio.
Good luck to all our Indiana teams. Domingo is up next with National Days. Let's see what National Days we can celebrate today.
Hello, I'm Domingo from Mrs. Leatherman's class, and welcome to this week's edition of National Days. Today, it is our zipper day. Be sure to wear a jacket with a zipper. On Saturday, it's Star Wars Day, and be sure to wear a fun costume for Star Wars Day. And of course, I will watch a Star Wars movie. On Sunday is Batman Day. Be sure to wear a Batman costume and celebrate. Thanks for tuning in with me on National Days. Now back to the studio with Drake and James.
Thank you, Domingo.
Hey, did you know that Did You Know was up next?
No, I didn't.
Well, next up is Sophia and Aniston with Did You Know.
Hi, Prairie Trace Hawks. My name is Aniston from Ms. Van Dam's class.
And I'm Sophia from Mrs. Ellen's class.
Welcome to Did You Know. Hey, Sophia, did you know that hot water can turn to ice faster than cold water?
No, that's crazy, but not as crazy as knowing that the smallest monkey is not even as tall as a toothbrush.
Wow, I never knew there was such a thing.
Hey, did you know that Dairy Queen makes their logo red and yellow because it makes you happy?
Oh, that's why their slogan is Happy Tastes Good.
Now I'm hungry for some of those Bosco sticks. From talking about food.
No, I don't think you were hungry because of that. I think you were just looking at the red and yellow on the Dairy Queen logo.
Red and yellow makes you happy, not hungry. I'm just hungry.
I know that, but it also makes you hungry.
Oh, wow, that's interesting. Colors are confusing and mess with my brain.
Wait, what do you mean?
I mean, for example, when you look at the color orange, you want to think of the fruit orange.
Oh, yeah, like when you look at the color yellow, it makes you dizzy.
Yeah, like red makes you feel mad or angry.
Oh, so it's like when you're mad to go back to the studio?
Yes, and speaking of going back to the studio...
Really? We already have to go back?
Yes, this is not going to last forever.
Oh, fine.
Thanks for watching.
Now back to the studio.
Thank you, Aniston and Sophia.
Hey, do you like pets?
Of course I do.
Well, next up is Ava with Pets on the Prairie.
Hi, I'm Ava from Miss Van Dam's class. Welcome to this edition of Pets on the Prairie. I'm here with...
Anna.
What's your pet's name?
My pet's name is Peg and Sydney, but we call my cat Peggy.
Oh, I love that name. Why did you choose to name her or him?
Well, we don't really have anything for Sydney, but for my cat, my dad's favorite song is called Peg, and that's the only way that we could get a new cat.
Is there any funny things that you'd like to tell me about your pet?
My dog, whenever my dad mows, she always goes out and, like, she rolls in the grass. So then after my mom vacuums, there's just grass everywhere.
Is there anything else you want to tell me?
No, that's it.
This is the end of this edition of Pets on the Prairie. I'm Ava.
And I'm Anna.
Back to the studio. Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
party was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I heard a poor one shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
Hi, I'm back. I'm Ava, and I'm from Miss Van Dam's class. I'm here with this edition of Petzl and Prairie. I'm here with
Daniel.
What's your pet's name?
Taco.
I like that name. Very interesting. Why did you choose to name him?
We choose to name him because he kind of looked like the Mexican food taco.
Is there any funny things that your pet does?
A funny thing that my pet does is he kind of chases around his little nub tail.
Is there anything else you want to tell me?
Yes. He also sometimes likes to kind of roll around in the grass for no reason at all.
Well, this is the end of this edition of Petzl and Prairie. I'm Ava.
And I'm Daniel.
Now, back to the studio.
Who let the dogs out? Was nice, the party was bumping. And everybody having a ball. Until the fellas started name calling. And the girls respond to the call. I heard a poor one shout out.
Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out? Who let the dogs out?
I see the young people had a ball, cause Billy Pongers get out. Scruffy, bus scruffy, get back, you flea infested mongrel. Gonna tell myself I man, no get angry.
Thanks, Ava.
Anna and Daniel's pets are so cute.
Up next is Daniel with current events.
Hi, I'm Daniel, and welcome to this week's current events. Elon Musk, the world's richest person, has bought Twitter, one of the world's largest social media sites, for $4 billion. Mr. Musk says he wants to protect free speeches, but many people worry about actions he take as Twitter's owner. Last Thursday, the U.S. Fish and the Wildfire Service announced that 6 red wolf pups have been born in the wild. That's great news for endangered red wolves, which marks the first time these pups have been born in the wild since 2018. Emmanuel Macron was elected as president of France last Sunday, defeating Marine Le Pen. It is the first time in 20 years that French president has been elected to second term. Thanks for tuning in. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, Daniel.
Next up, we have Malek with Teacher Feature.
Good morning, Prairie Trace Hawks. I'm Malek from Mrs. Lillman's class, and I'm here with Mrs. Kimmel. Hi, Mrs. Kimmel.
Hi, Malek.
I'm going to ask you a few questions.
Awesome.
What job did you want to have as a kid?
I remember at my preschool graduation, I told everyone I wanted to be a cowgirl. I have no idea where that came from, but that's what I said at my kindergarten or my preschool graduation.
If you were not a fourth grade teacher, what grade would you want to teach?
Oh, I do love fourth grade. If I couldn't teach fourth grade, probably somewhere still up in the upper elementary, maybe fifth grade or third grade, but somewhere older usually.
Mm-hmm. Did you have other jobs in mind before you went to college?
I sure did. Growing up, I went through lots of different jobs I thought I might want. For a while, I wanted to be a chef. Then I wanted to be a real estate agent. After that, I realized I liked working with kids, though, and so for a while, I looked into possibly being a social worker and helping kids with lots of different areas of life, but then I realized that my true passion was seeing the same kids every day and teaching them, so that's what led me there.
If you had to choose, would you stay with last year's class or this year's?
Oh, man, you can't make me choose that. Can I just have them both?
No.
Oh, I really want them both. I really can't answer that.
No, okay, we're almost done. If you could go back in time as a teacher, what would you have done differently?
That's a great question for reflection. Every year I always think of things that like I would change or do differently. I don't know if one certain thing stands out. Maybe just trying to teach things in a bit of a different way or trying different activities. I don't know if I can come up with one on the spot for you, though. Something I would do differently. Probably some more games, though.
Okay, last one. If you could choose one thing in your teaching years that was the funniest thing you ever experienced, what would it be?
Oh, man. I think some of the funniest things that we've done were, do you remember at the beginning of the year when we were learning about the growth mindset and we dressed up as Russell from Up, the movie Up?
Yeah.
And getting to dress up with some of the other teachers, too, I think is one of the funniest things that we've done. Just walking around the building in costume. Such a silly thing.
Thank you, Ms. Kimmel, for joining me, Malek, and Teacher Feature. Thanks for tuning in. Now back to the studio.
Thank you, Malek.
Next up, we have Anna with Mystery Baby.
Hi, I'm Anna from Mrs. Leatherman's class, and welcome to this week's edition of Mystery Baby. Last week's Mystery Baby was Miss Winkle, and the winner is Adrian from Miss Winkle's class. Our new hints for our Mystery Baby are: I grew up in Carmel and graduated in the year 2000. My mom, sister, and I are all teachers in Carmel. My favorite place for vacation is the beach. If you have any guesses, put your name and teacher's name on a post-it note and hand it to your teacher. That's it for this week's edition of Mystery Baby. Now back to the studio.
Thank you, Anna.
Finally, we have Grayson with Person of the Week.
Hi, I am Grayson, and welcome to Person of the Week. Today's Person of the Week is Franklin D. Roosevelt. Here are some cool facts about him. He was the 32nd president and was the only president who served in three terms. He led to the U.S. through two world crises, such as World War II and the Great Depression. He lived and grew up in a luxurious home, and he was homeschooled until he was 14. He got into Harvard University and was working towards gaining a role in the government. He died on April 12th of 1945 at the age of 63. I'm Grayson. Now back to the studio. That's all for WPTE.
I'm Drake.
And I'm James.
We will end with the national anthem, leadership pledge, and a moment of silence. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you on the prairie.
What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming.
I pledge, as a Prairie Trace Elementary leader, to have a positive attitude each day. I will make good choices even when no one is looking. I will demonstrate the 8 habits to make myself and my school an amazing place.